Yes, I can see my people coming in. Thank you very much. Akabo Soreto, Sister Mida, Princess, Princess Fem Bodyline. Thank you very much. Eshe Goni, Odua, Michael, Olusheye, Eshe Goni. Well, Ade Otu Fale, my evangelist, Eshe Ngoni. Evangelist mi dada eku esin ni o. Thank you very much. E seun e kaabo sori eto gbogbo eyin te de join me last time na mo fi wo yi ati asiko yi. Mo fi dupe lowo gbogbo yin wi pe e seun eku igba gbogbo mi. Toro mi o sun yin e se oro yin na koni sun Olorun Eledumare. Odua Michael Olusheye, happy Sunday. Happy Sunday to you too, my darling brother. Morenika Adeloso Yobaze, you are welcome, my darling sister. The Princess Femi Bodyline, I'm with you, ma. Happy Sunday. Happy Sunday to you too, my darling sister. I share on gone you. I ku isimi enio. I want to moshiri oru kwa loke ni mungpe yen. Quiet numbers of people are here, but I want to oru kwa wanchi pop up ni. I want ni mung fi wo iti mo finki yen. Ti oruko awon to kuna ba tin come up mama pe yin ma de ma kiyin tori wi pe eni to ba pon ni le Yoruba lo so be won ni eni to ba pon ni le la ma pon le so be se pon mi le emi na gbodo ma pon yin le mi gbodo foju pa yin re e seun gan ni e kaabo sori eto. The story I'm going to bring to your hearing today me ni so ni Yoruba because Ade Otufale, happy Sunday to you, sir. E seun gan ni. Awon eyan tin pe mi late kan pe ah, gba oni mo ma bo sori line mo ni mi ni pe ago marun lo ye kin de bi bayi. Sugbon e mo en to ba ti lawon omo. So, mo so mo tun ni baby. So, ko je kin tete bo si ori line. E seun gan ni. And thanks to my darling husband. Awon lo ba mi take care ile lowo nsin. E se gan ni. So, as I was saying, I'm not going to do today's video in Yoruba. The reason being that the person that gave me this story is not a Yoruba lady or woman. She is an Igbo, I believe. So, and she has told me that I should please do it in English so that she could at least understand what I'm saying about her and about her story. Well, he gave me permission that I could mix it with English, Yoruba with English together. You know, a little bit of Yoruba in it for the benefit of, well, mo believe where everybody understand English, you know. Although, our uncle, our brother said the other time, Sir Shina Peter won ni grammar no be my language but at the same time gbogbo alagboyinbo. So thank you very much everyone for listening to me today. Before I start this story, I would like to to welcome everyone aboard. And I would like to say thank you very much to everybody for supporting me, because without you, there's no me. So I'm very grateful and I appreciate every one of you. Odudua, Michael, Olusheye, I'm a lady, ma. Oh, sorry, I don't stay, live in Dublin. As I saw Michael, I'm very sorry, I thought you were a man. Okay, my darling sister, my mistake, pardon me, please. Odua, Michael, Olusheye, Eshengon, Ekabo, Soreto. Se gomi imo gba ti mo ti ri Michael mo ro pe Michael yen ni oruko yin gangan so bo ye oruko oko yin o so but e kaabo sori eto e seun gan ni. So I will start this story straight away. I will not want to waste time at all. Bi gege bi ise mi mo ma tete so story yen. This sister, we are in the same group on Facebook. There's a group on Facebook. I'm not going to mention the name of the group now, but I saw her story on the group page, and I discussed with her because the story was so emotional. You know, I felt so pity for her, and I talked to her, and she told me, she gave me permission to bring this story live and to talk about this story on my live video. So she gave me her story, and I would like every one of us to listen very carefully, and please, because she needs our help to locate where her two children are. She saw them last in, she saw them last in 2011. I don't want to make any mistake now. Me, Tiri Bitimo Kosi, but I will look for it. I saw my children last in November 2011. So I'm going to start the story. She's trying to locate where her ex-husband took her children, because she has seen the children last in 2011. And you know, Omomeji, two children, a boy and a girl. I'm a woman, I'm a mother, you know. So I can understand her and I can even feel her pain. So she said my name is, she permitted me to mention names. So I'm not doing this without her consent. So she gave me consent to mention names in this program. So I'm going to mention names because she's looking for her children. So to be able to help her to trace, or anyone that, you know, anybody can even hear this name and say, oh, I know this person, I know where the children are. So that's why we are going to mention name. Basirat Shonekan Umaru, I enjoy your program, sister. God will continue to bless you. Thank you very much, my darling sister. Thanks for supporting me. Abiola Arun Ajishafe, nice program. You are welcome aboard, my darling sister. Thank you very much. I have beautiful people online. I can see your pictures. You are all beautiful. Thank you. God bless you. So her name is Ife. Maybe I should be reading it like as if it's happening to me, like, you know, so that the story will be straightforward. As she gave me the story, I should just be reading it out to you. She said, my name is Ifewa Onyenema. I'm not an Igbo lady, so just take it as I'm calling, as I can able to call it the names. I mean, her name is Ifewa Onyemena. I just finished my university, then I met my ex-husband in 2006. My ex-husband is from Okwele. I believe I pronounce it properly. Okwele is Okwele. Okwele in Imo State. We got married in August 2008. They had traditional marriage. I gave birth to a baby girl in May 4th, 2009 in South Africa. They traveled together when she was pregnant. She traveled with her husband to South Africa, where she gave birth to her baby girl. When we came back from South Africa, my husband changed the name on my passport to his surname. He changed the name from Onyemena to Uzowuru. That's the name of the man, the family name of the man, Uzowuru. I'm going to spell it out to you. It's U-Z-O-W-U-R-U. U-Z-O-W-U-R-U. That is the man's surname. In October 2009, I went for my youth service. He insisted that we have court wedding, which we did, so that they could transfer me or I could be redeployed to Lagos. They did the court wedding. We did the court wedding on the 15th of October 2009 at Ikoyi Registry. After the wedding, he said he hardly sleep at home, the man. He said the man will go out and he will not come back. He started treating her, you know, anyhow. After the wedding, the man changed from a very nice man that he used to be to another thing, you know. He always go clubbing, you know. He has chains of girlfriends. He treated me as if I'm not his wife. He had no respect for me or my family. That is how the lady gave me the story. Bon she fun mi ni mo se nka fun yin. Emma Binu, Lucy Olayeka. Thank you very much, my darling sister Lucy. Ayinde Lukman, very inspiring and informative. Thank you, sir. Thank you very much. I can't see your picture, but from that name, I believe you're a man. So, Ayinde Lukman, thank you very much. He beats me all the time. He said he doesn't want to live with any woman. He just wants to have kids, children with women. So, as things were going on, all of a sudden, he started to sell their properties. The man has chains of properties. So he started selling his properties. The lady told me on phone. I did not write that down. The lady said the man is all this yahoo, you know, like konishe kan pato to se awon bet awon ton jam ton jagba bi jagba lo mo jagba, you know, like awon yahoo. So when he now got broke, but the business as bo se man so awon irun awon eyan be yan group won e bo je ma ni ko si business o yo kota. So he started selling his properties. He was even going to sell the house they were living in Lekki, but she refused. We won ni lesi Lekki, so she did not let him. She said when okay, all of a sudden he started selling his properties. I challenged him and I asked him, why is he selling his property? We have children together. What will be the children inheritance when you go, if you sell all these properties now? And the man told her, her ex-husband answered her and said, I don't want to leave this. What's the point leaving things for my children? After all, my dad did not leave anything for me. That was the man's answer to the lady then. Said my mom came visited on 11th of January 2011. He asked me to send my mom away immediately. There was an argument over this and he said he will kill me after my mom had gone. After my mom left, he beat me up. In February 2011, he left the house. He left me with the two children, a boy and a girl, and he traveled to Spain. Since I was not working because he refused that I work then, he didn't allow me to work. Things were so hard for me and my children. I went through hardship. I suffered a lot with my children. In July 2011, I felt sick and was taken to hospital. And the doctor said I was suffering from malaria. While I was at the hospital, his sister came to see me. So when I was discharged, his sister was with me. On her way home, she collected the prescription paper given to me by the doctor. Prescription, you know, drug prescriptions. Paper ton fun pe ko fi gbogun abi ko fi ra ogun. A ma gbogun bi ni, won ma ro ogun lohun ni. So, she collected the prescription paper that was given to me and went to the chemist to get the drugs. The sister's name is Joy Chigeku. Joy Chigeku. The surname is spelled like this: Chigekwu. Chigekwu. Joy Chigeku. When we got home, I took the drug and continued to finish the drugs, the course. After a while, I started reacting to the drugs negatively. It affected my mental health. I called my brother and I told him that I don't know what was happening to me. I was mentally unstable. One day, the second day, I think, the sister prepared my food. After eating the food, I started bleeding. Immediately after I finished eating the food, I started bleeding. Then, she took me to their elder sister's house. Faderera Adeniyi Kuku. I read this story in a closed Facebook group. Did the woman also share this story with you, ma? Sorry, I'm just asking. Well, you are just coming in, my dear sister. So I've said earlier on that she gave me permission. We talk on phone. I hope that answers your question, ma. We talked on phone and she said I should please share this story live on my program. Thank you very much as you are coming in. So, she took me to their elder sister's house. They invited a doctor. Following their brother's instruction on phone, their brother instructed them. So, they took me to a doctor who gave me an injection. After giving me the injection, I was unconscious. I started shouting and crying. Then they tied me up with rope. They tied my hands and my legs with rope. There were three of them, the two sisters and their house boy. They started laughing at me and calling me names like prayer warrior. They said to me, "I think you know how to pray. Start to pray now for your God to come and rescue you." So my brother eventually told my mother what I was going through, and my mother sent my siblings to go and get me. Faderera Adeniyi Kuku, apologies, ma. I just needed to confirm, ma. Thanks for clarifying. You are welcome, my darling sister, and thanks for joining me in my program. My mother and my siblings took me to church, and they did deliverance for me. After the deliverance, I felt okay. I was okay. Now, when the doctor gave me that injection, he tried to cover up the injection, the syringe, I think, for her not to know the name of the injection. So she did not know the name of the injection. So I was with my mother, and my children were with the sisters. They did not release my children for me. Whenever I called to ask for my children, the sisters will ask my daughter to abuse me. My daughter, 3 years old then, will start to abuse me on phone and calling me prostitute, that she didn't want to talk to me. I saw my children last in November 2011. I later heard that he has taken my children to America. The sisters burnt all my belongings in our Lekki house. I was not allowed to take anything. Please help me in locate my children. I'm suffering in silence emotionally. Please, I need to see my children. I love my children and I miss them so much. That is the end of my story. Ejo, I mo lero pe gbogbo wa la gbo story yi. The Princess Fem Bodyline. Kings can't inherit from another man's sweat. Yahoo. Folashade Omolabi Owolabi, you are doing very well. Thanks for your words of wisdom. Thank you, my sister. You are welcome to this program. Please, everyone, this lady really needs our help, because when she was talking to me, she was actually crying. And I can understand what she's going through. Her children, two children, a boy and a girl, she has seen them last in 2011. So anybody that has a clue, that is why I tried to mention names. I called the name of the husband. The surname of the husband, that's, I think, is the only the surname that she gave to me. The surname is Uzowuru, Uzowuru. She gave me the picture. She gave me she sent the husband pictures and the children picture to me, which I'm going to try and share on my page or on my Facebook timeline. Please, after this program, because she gave me permission, so I told her, so one sent pictures and see me. She gave me the picture, and I'm going to share the picture later so that everyone can see the husband picture and her children. So, this program, I believe that people are watching me all over. I have fans in America, Germany, everywhere. You know, it's Facebook. So, they're watching this program everywhere. So if you're in America, please, we believe these children, they are in America. I'm still going to talk to the sister. I want to know if she has a clue of the particular state that the children are in America, so that I can mention it in my next program. So I can mention the name of the state. So if anybody come across or has a clue of where the children is, she please contact me on my Facebook. You can inbox me. Liz Falashade Olakanye Adesuyan, well done, ma. My darling sister, my beautiful sister, thank you. Otojometa Shalafia. The Liz Beth, the very foundation of this relationship was based on fraud, lies and greed. Thank you, Liz Beth. She didn't state when she delivered the boy, how she got back to Nigeria. Okay. Let her bring the complete name of the man. Okay. The name she's giving is not enough to locate the man. Okay. Well done. Caro Umakwe. Well done. Ajika Jesus said the name she's giving is not enough to locate the man. Ajika Jesus said, let her bring the complete name of the man. Okay, ma. Liz Beth, regardless, if she's mentally and financially stable, she can work with the police and some NGOs to get the kids. Titi Layo, Bisiolu, well done, ma. Thank you, my sister. Otumba Alex Adeleye, well done, ma. Thank you. Thank you very much, Otumba. She said when she met the man, she was 23 years old. She just finished her university, so she was quite young then. So I just forgot to mention that earlier on. Thank you, everyone. Adunia De Omoshunyan, my darling sister. Thank you very much. So that's the end of the story. I will get more information, like my sister, what's the name? Ajika Jesus said that the name she gave was not enough to locate the man. Like I said to you, she only gave me the surname of the man. She gave me their sister's name and their surname. She sent the picture to me, which I'm going to paste on my page or my Facebook timeline after I finish this video now. So that is all about the story. I have two other stories, fantastic story that I'm going to do. Not tonight, I will try to do one tomorrow or Tuesday. So it's a true life story as well. Lizbeth, if you have the picture, ma, we all can put it up. I will after this program because she sent it to me. So it's in my inbox. Well done, sister Princess Lolo Omochami. Thank you very much, my dear princess. It has worked in the past. Okay, it will work again. Lizbeth, thank you very much. I believe this will work. I believe she will have her children back. Last time, some people were asking me, let me play the music again. Many people, they even sent messages to me. They inbox me that they want to know who did that music. They want to know the name of the music. One of them more and talk only Timo and Josipe or in Yakodungoni Christian music ni modernity patterns. It will be 4 or 5 years. So I will just let me play it a bit so that we enjoy it together. Then I will remove the CD and show you the CD so that if you want to get it, you can go and get it. And I can play. Hey Joe, Emi ole play music last night. Ma Joe, mo wo yin ni bi te wa gbogbo yin so e ba mi fe se rajo die. E seun gan ni. Thank you, Jesus. Princess, Lolo, you are dancing. Okay, I could see you are dancing, but you are sitting there because I can see you. So stand up, let's dance together. Okay, now. I'm dancing too. Okay, now I can see. All right, I'm going to remove this CD now. And the name of the person, the prophetess that sang this song, is Prophetess Duni Olanrewaju, aka Ologo and Her Covenant of Glory, Spiritual Voice of God. And the title of the album is Sacrifice of Praise. If you can see. Okay, multi bass sister, Polo Waja, Kia, my wife, phone number, one can't keep telling me my bow. And you'll let me lay bay of Polo Waja, love her. Oh, Gaju. Anyway, thank you very much, everyone. Ah, Roger Musolo Kuo. Oju Ale. Oh, shaking it on your back by your baby career. Oh, John Rabia, no. Oh, John Rabia, no. Thank you very much, everyone. Everyone. Eshon Goni Modupe Dupe. Like I've said earlier on, Princess Lolo Mochami, I'm at work. You're at work and you're dancing. Hey, Emi Osimbe, me, I'm not there. Oh. Come on, Osaki, Oluwe, Ejo. Morenika, they lost all your baze. My head is dancing. It's only your head that is dancing. These people will kill me with love today. Stella, hey, Akini Bosun. I'm dancing with you, a girlfriend. That'd be Sunday. Thank you, my darling friend, though. Is it only your hand that is dancing? Because that sister, Morenika, said my head is dancing. What about you, my girlfriend? Is it your leg or your hand that is dancing? Me, Bogbara, me, Mofinjo, can see. Oh, Gaju. Eshengoni, I love every one of you. Because without you, there's no me. I'm enjoying this with you. I'm enjoying you people as you're enjoying me. Eshengoni, thank you very much. Gaga bi ise mi Princess Lolo Mochami, hi, my boss. Sheninu Ijosha. Anyway, don't worry. One day, everyone will just call a pattern. You tell one Nigeria. I thought I would be a party. I want my Joe. I patile. I want to my Joju. Anyway, Eshongon, thanks very much. I appreciate every one of you. Gẹ́gẹ́ bí ṣe mi èmi ò ní lọ láì gbàdúrà fún yín o torí àdúrà yín ń gbà lórí mi mo dẹ̀ lérò pé tèmi náà máa gbà lórí yín mo gbàdúrà wípé ojú tẹ fi ń wò mí kò ní fọ́ etí tẹ fi ń gbọ́ mi kò ní di a máa lọ síwájú ni àní lọ sẹ́yìn lágbára ọlọ́run àní fojú sunkún. No weapon fashioned against us shall prosper in Jesus' name. The Lord will continually be our Alpha and Omega. Lagbara lowo Olorun. Oluwa oni fi wa sile koni pada leyin wa gbogbo wa patapata. Odun ton lo sofin koni di wa meru lo. Favor shall locate us and be our portion in Jesus' name. Everything we lay our hands upon from today on will prosper in Jesus' name. A ni foju sunkun omo ani faragba we omo. A ni sopo osun gangan. Oko na oni foju sunkun wa lagbara lowo Eledumare. Nigba ta ba tun ma pada wa sori eto yi, won ni nikan dide iseju kan feyan kankan ninu wa lagbara lowo Eledumare. Orun ta ma sun lale yi orun ayo ni o. Awa la ma sun, awa na la de ma ji. Won ni fe gba ji wa laaro la lagbara Olorun. Won ni ni e ba mi gba boyo ma laju lagbara lowo Eledua ni saisan nigba ta ba ma ji laaro la ani bara wa ni lewosan ani bara wa ni bere agan lagbara lowo Eledumare e seun gan ni ejo bi mo se n gbadura fun yin e na ma gbadura fun wa adura n pojo adura ni opa Christiani e seun o well ni bi bayi ni ma fi adagba eto toni ro si to ba tun di ni ola abi titi ojo meta e tun pade mi but I will make sure well Facebook ma notify yin na awon ti mo de tun ma npe ti ma so fun ton ma ni ki so fa awon tori awon le ma si lori Facebook mo promise yin ti ba ti fe bo sori eto ma notify yin funra mi e seun gan ni everyone thank you very much layo la tun ma pade I love you all thank you bye.